I'm going to go over some strategies on how we can integrate the product of tangent to some power and secant to some power. Let's take a look right here. In terms of integration-wise, tangent x and secant x, they are best friends. And if we can have the integral in this form, as you can see, if we have secant squared x dx on the side, and then if we can make the first part in terms of tangent x, hopefully this is a nice expression, easy enough. That's in terms of tangent x. Then we can just use u substitution, say u is equal to tangent x, because we know du will be secant squared x dx, and this will match with that, right? And on the other hand, if we have the integral in this form, if we have secant x tangent x dx on the side, and the first part is an expression, hopefully it's easy enough, that is in terms of secant x, then we can let u is equal to secant x, then we see du is equal to secant x times tangent x dx, which is this part. These two are the general strategy. And of course, we'll utilize the trig identities for tangent square and secant square x, okay, just like this. Here is an example. We have the integral tangent square x times secant to the fourth power x. Let's take a look. Which one can we make them happen? Can we make the first one happen? Let's give it a try. And let me just put this down on the side for you guys. If I want to make the first situation, that means I hope to break this integral apart in terms of, well, I have the first part here, and then multiply with secant squared x dx, like this, right? Well, we have secant to the fourth power. I took away two of them, I put it on the side. So originally this was this, and now we'll just take this part, put in the parentheses. We will have just tangent square x, that doesn't change. But then it was to the fourth power, we took two away, so we have secant square x in the first parentheses. So this is how I would like to make the first part happen. Can we also try to make the second part, like the second strategy happen? If I want to do that, okay, I have the integral, the first part, and then I want to take out secant x tangent x dx and put it on the side. So let me write that down. Secant x tangent x dx, let me put it on the side. Originally, the integral was this. We have the second part for tangent, but I took out one of them, right? So we have just tangent x inside. Originally, we have to the fourth power for secant. I took one out, so we have secant to the third power inside. So far, so good. It seems that I can make both of them happen. But let's continue, okay? For the first situation, if we have the secant squared x and on the side, hopefully the first part is in terms of tangent x. We have tangent squared x, this right here, this is good. And can we rewrite secant squared in terms of tangent? Yes, we can, because we know secant squared x is immediately tangent squared x plus 1. So I can just change this right away, and then you will see this is the same as integrating tangent squared x times tangent, because secant squared is the same as tangent squared x plus 1. Right, this is still the first part. And then I have the secant squared x dx on the side. And this right here, it's an easy enough expression in terms of tangent, okay? How about let's take a look at this one. I put secant x tangent x dx on the side, right? So I hope to have the first part in terms of secant x. We have secant to the third power x. This is good. I'm not going to touch this. But then for tangent x, how can I rewrite that in terms of secant x? Well, you see, we have tangent squared x. This is equal to that. But this was to the second power. And you may be wondering, can we just take the square root? Yes, we can. If you want to say tangent x, because I just have that to the first power, if you want to make this, okay, I will take the square root. But then keep in mind, you also have to take the square root right here. And in that case, I don't think the expression right here, it will be an easy enough expression in terms of secant, because we introduced this square root, and that's bad, right? In several situations. So I'm not going to continue with this. I will just keep working with that. Okay? So once again, I don't want to use square root if necessary, if possible. And we can avoid that by use the first strategy. And we'll continue from there. Well, for the first part, it's an expression easy enough in terms of tangent. I can just let u equals to tangent x. Then immediately we can differentiate both sides. Du will be secant square x dx, and let me take this integral into the u world. I'll put it down right here. This will be the integral. This tangent is going to be u, but that was to a second power. We have u square, and then we have the parentheses. Tangent square, once again, that will be u square plus 1, right? And that was this right here. And then what's this? Secant square x dx. That match exactly the same as du. This is just du. And you see, we took this integral into the u world right away. And the best part is, if I can just distribute the u squared into the parentheses, this integral will be so much easier to integrate in the u world compared to the square root one that I erased earlier. Let me continue. This is the same as integrating u squared times u squared, that's u to the fourth power, u squared times positive 1, that's plus u squared, and this is du. So finally, we can integrate. Integral of u to the fourth power, this is 1/5, u to the fifth power. Integral of u to the second power, this is plus, because positive, 1/3 u to the third power. We are not done yet, because this is in the u world. Finally, I'm going to just take this into the take back to the x world. We will have 1/5. U is tangent x, so we have tangent to the fifth power x plus 1/3 tangent to the third power x, and then we are done. So at the end, I put a plus c, and this is it.